Students, today I am there before you again with another revision video of chapter number 2 of the book Footprints Without Feet, The Thief Story. You have already read the story, I have already taught you this chapter, but to make this chapter more clear to you, I have decided to make this video so that I can teach the brief summary of this chapter to you. So watch this video carefully and read the chapter thoroughly. Let's start the summary. This chapter is completely based upon the thief whose name is Hari Singh and his master Anil, who is a bachelor and a careless master. He was not a regular earner. He wrote for magazines. He was a magazine writer. So one day Hari Singh was a thief and he wanted to rob the Anil also. That's why he went to the Anil and requested him to be his cook. At this, Anil asked to the Hari Singh, "Do you know how to cook the food?" And he replied and said, "Yes," agreed that, "Yes, I know how to cook." But in fact, Hari Singh did not know how to cook the food. So, but Anil said to Hari Singh that, "Okay, you can come to my house, you can be my servant, but I cannot pay you. I don't have the money to give you the salary." At this, Hari Singh took a pause, thought about this thing and then said, "Yes, okay, no issue. I don't require the money, but you can give me the meal of the day. Means 3 meals of the day. Breakfast, lunch and dinner." Anil agreed and Anil said, "Okay, you can come to my house." Now they both went together. After some days, or on the very first day, when Hari Singh cooked the food for Anil, Anil understood this thing that Hari Singh doesn't know how to cook the food. But side by side, Anil was teaching something to Hari Singh, like how to write sentences, how to write the name, alphabets, everything he was trying to teach the Hari Singh so that Hari Singh could make himself able to write something. But after some days, as I told you that, he was a magazine writer. Anil was a magazine writer, but somewhere he was a careless person also. He didn't care about his money. He always spent his money on his friends also. He wanted to hang out with friends. That's why he went outside and spent the money on his friends. But he didn't have the money to pay the Hari Singh. One day, Hari Singh noticed that Anil brought a bundle of notes with him. And what did he do? Anil kept that bundle of notes under his pillow and then slept on that pillow. So, but Hari Singh wanted to rob that bundle of notes. That's why he took out that bundle of notes under the pillow of Anil, and just ran away from that place. On the way, when he was going to the station, on the way it started raining, and when he reached the railway station, he could not catch the train. The train was just moving before him, but he could not catch the train. Somewhere in his heart, his soul was saying to him that you did very wrong. The person who had deep faith in you, who was teaching you how to write the sentences, you robbed the same person. So that's why he decided to go back to Anil. So when he was going back to Anil, it started raining heavily and he kept that bundle of notes under his pajama. And that bundle of notes was completely wet. So when he reached at Anil's house again, he kept the bundle of notes in the same place. Next morning, when Anil woke up and Hari Singh woke up, Anil observed this thing that the bundle of notes is wet. It means he has stolen that bundle of notes, but he had come again and just placed that bundle of notes again under my pillow. What happened after that? Anil took out one note from that bundle and gave that note to Hari Singh and said that from today onwards, I will pay you for your work. At this, Hari Singh got shocked because that note was still wet. Hari Singh got shocked and thought that he did not give me any punishment, and still he observed that, yes, I have stolen his money, but he didn't say anything to me. That was a matter of surprise for Anil and Hari Singh, both of the persons, but he didn't say anything to him. Hari Singh used to keep 1 rupee from the money that Anil used to give him to buy the vegetables. But he didn't say anything to Anil that I have kept 1 rupee coin from the money that you have given me. Means he used to rob Anil, he used to do the stealing, but he didn't make Anil realize that I'm stealing something from your money. Anil realized everything and then still he taught Hari Singh how to write sentences and how to be an educated person. And then Hari Singh realized that this is just a bundle of notes. I can spend this money in a week. I can use this money for the week or the 2 weeks. But when I will be an educated person, I will earn so much of money and I will gain the respect also. So that respect will be much more better than this bundle of notes. That's why he kept that bundle of notes again under the pillow. So that was the story and the summary of this chapter. I hope you have understood this chapter. After watching this video, you will have to read the chapter thoroughly to understand it more better. Okay, still if you have any doubt, any problem, you can text me or call me anytime. I'll solve your problem. I'll help you to solve your problem. Read the chapter thoroughly. Okay, all the best.